Thus said the Lord, set thine house in order. Set thy house in order, for thou shalt die and not live. Set thy house in order. What was the prophet told Isaiah? If I come to you, excellencies, now and tell you, set your house or set your state in order, you will die. You will send the SS behind me. But if they come, the angels of God will defend them or defend me. We tell me, Archbishop, I don't believe in 70 years. 70 years, although said by David in the psalm we read or sang, is not the age for one to die. 70 years is the age of retirement. Politicians, are you hearing me? Politicians, are you hearing me? 70 is the age of retirement. At 70, you get your passport to heaven. 80, you get your visa. 90, you get your ticket. 100, you get your boarding pass. 120, you fly. And the federal government said, fly him to London for overseas treatment. Which again, I must say, is a good idea. But it's a shame to Nigeria that many of you big men cannot be treated in Nigeria. Flowing our blood abroad is a disgrace to our health circle. We must do something about that. Not continue carrying our vice president, presidents abroad when they cannot be even a Panadol in the government, federal government's state house clinic. I hope there's Panadol now. I hope the x-ray machine is working there. That is the first place to start fighting corruption. Politicians, listen to this. This man has something he was doing before he got into politics. Because some of you are in politics, you don't have anything doing. Hence, you are recycling yourself day by day. He was a technical consultant to the World Bank's educational project. Because Ekweme did not believe in bribery. He did not believe in rigging. Today, when conventions are made in any of the parties, people carry Ghana Must Go all around to make campaigns to get themselves elected. And that is why Nigeria has continued to be corrupt. Even the present government came by corruption. So it is difficult to fight corruption. I once confronted the head of state. I said, those who stole the state money used their state money to campaign for the presidency of Nigeria. And so they are all given three states or three ministries. That is corruption. Many of you, we ask yourself as politicians today, because this is one of the legacies you must learn from. He entered politics. He left it with poverty. Some of you had nothing. Even local government chairmen, I know some of them, who had nothing. Before they left, they had built two houses. And governors must begin to look at these chairmen, starting from them, who have embezzled money rather than doing some work in local government. Nobody, the governors, and those only Mazihini. President Buhari, today, has paid a tribute to Ekweme. Unfortunately, 32 years ago, Buhari put Ekweme into prisons. And 32 years after, Ekweme is dying in Buhari's government. To say that you people in the National Assembly should be very careful and should promulgate a law to stop this cross-carpeting of party members from one party to the other. That is political prostitution. You must stop it. It's a disgrace. It's selfishness. I cannot imagine somebody who gained electoral post into position in the Senate coming now at a point in time to desert that party and crossing over. It is not right. If you cross over, then you must leave that party. If you leave that party, you leave your post. That is our own submission. Two, Southeast will not tolerate any colony. No colony for any Fulani house man. Any governor that does it will be resisted. We in Kan will resist any of you governors that we bring any colony here. We don't want any colonization. Housemen should stay away. It's a private business. Audobe should take them to Daura, Sambisa Forest. We don't want them here. The python dance we have here is enough. And they must go. Also, I want to say here that as far as we are concerned as Igbos, we are very hardworking people. We must be recognized and must not be marginalized. Our governors must be united. Igbos must be united. Let us stand as one voice, as Ekweme stood for us, who again will stand as our unifying figure. Odumegwu has gone. Ekweme has gone. Zeke of Africa has gone. Onyenimunu ga nojifa. Onyenimunu ga nojifa. Onyenimunu ga nojifa. This is the question. Because the politics you are playing now is the politics of selfishness, materialistic tendencies, and aggrandizement. And it's time you must begin to think selflessly on how to really talk about how to eradicate poverty in our land. Agud in Obodo. Agud in Obodo. Unemployment itself is worrying our youths. Let us begin to think about if you have money, create employment for the youths and there will be no agitation. Recycling yourself into policies with the money you have is a big disgrace. And if you have money, show it by investing and let us have more employment. How have you spent or how are you spending your position? Anybody on top of position should please, for God's sake, remember those who are low behind this, before you. And you should know that one day you leave this post. I saw a governor who was ex-governor, who will not allow people to come near him. But when he retired or was voted out, I saw him at the airport. Nobody was ready to carry his bag. But when I came down, people were struggling for my bag. Hence, I said to myself, because I'm a mellow madam. People come near me. Governors, make yourself accessible. Buruburu is a man who makes himself accessible in Enugu here. And so, even though when you finish your second term, nobody will run away from you. The same thing, all the governors, Ebonyi State, Abia State, make yourself available to your people. Please make sure you eradicate poverty in your states. Also, Imo State, Anambra State, please, and all of you who are politicians, stop blowing these sirens for nothing. If you are blowing siren, what is the siren for? Is the siren for us or for your own selfishness? Time is coming if you don't take time. If you don't take care of us, we shall block you and your siren. And you will go nowhere. Because we elected you there. And you must go back to your constituency. May God help us all in Nigeria. And all of us to be ready for a new Nigeria. A new Nigeria needs people who are new in brain, not expired and analog brains. That is the finality. Let all those who are 70 years in politics go and retire. Anybody above 65 years should not be president of Nigeria. That is the limit you must seal. Let them become consultants and advisors. The people who are really hot in brain and technocrats are waiting to become leaders and let them do Nigeria well. Rather than this analog and all the cabals, let them go and rest. Because Nigeria needs a new brain and a new spirit. We cannot put a new wine into an old wineskin. Jesus.